Good afternoon, and welcome to the Immunization Action Coalition's webinar broadcast live from Albany Medical Center in New York. My name is Dr. Deborah Blog. I am the Director of the Division of Epidemiology at the New York State Department of Health, and I am pleased to be your moderator for this event, Give Birth to the End of Hepatitis B. The webinar has been timed to coincide with the launch of the Immunization Action Coalition's new book, Hepatitis B, What Hospitals Need to Do to Protect Newborns, a resource for birthing institutions to prevent perinatal transmission. Our webinar today focuses on the administration of the hepatitis B birth dose as a key strategy for preventing the transmission of hepatitis B from mother to baby. We are pleased that New York State's Albany Medical Center is being honored for their 99% birth dose rate. Mary Miller from Albany Medical Center is here today to share their experiences and efforts to achieve this remarkable goal. We also want to acknowledge the collaboration between federal, state, and county governments to promote CDC recommendations and enforce New York State laws and regulations. The New York State Department of Health Perinatal Hepatitis B Prevention Program came into existence after passage of a public health law in 1990 mandating hepatitis surface antigen screening of all pregnant women. As the former immunization program medical director and then director for the Bureau of Immunization at the State Department of Health, I have been a strong supporter of the perinatal hepatitis B prevention program. During my tenure with New York State Department of Health Immunization, we strengthened hospital oversight of New York State laws and regulations, implemented electronic surveillance and case management of infants born to hepatitis surface antigen positive women, developed the birth dose initiative in 2003, which Lynn Pollock will be discussing, and conducted surveys to identify barriers to the hepatitis B birth dose and best practices for administering birth dose. And finally, in 2006, we established giving the hepatitis B birth dose to all eligible newborns within 12 hours of birth as a standard of care in New York State. Here's the agenda and overview of the agenda for today's webinar. Our first speaker is Dr. Trudy Murphy of the Vaccine Research and Policy Team in the Division of Hepatitis at the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. Dr. Murphy will discuss the disease overview and recommendations. Our next speakers are Lynn Pollock, New York State Department of Health Perinatal Hepatitis B Coordinator, and Mary Miller, the Maternity Nurse Manager for Albany Medical Center's Birthplace. They will be presenting a case study on implementing the hepatitis B birth dose. Our final speaker is Dr. Deborah Wexler. Dr. Wexler is the well-known founder and executive director of the Immunization Action Coalition, or IAC. Those of us in the field of immunization have come to rely on IAC materials for ourselves, our providers, and patients. Dr. Wexler is here to tell us about an exciting new resource developed for hospital personnel. I just wanted to mention that we are not taking questions at the end of this presentation, but that questions may be submitted online, and we will do our best to answer them in an FAQ to be posted later on IAC's website, www.immunize.org. You can also send general questions and inquiries about this campaign, Give Birth to the End of Hepatitis B, and those can be emailed to birthdose@immunize.org. However, if there are any technical issues, please enter them into the live chat and they will be addressed. We will now be starting with Dr. Trudy Murphy's presentation.
Good morning and good afternoon. Thank you, Dr. Blog. Hepatitis B is a liver disease caused by the hepatitis B virus, or HBV. Hepatitis B virus is found in blood and body fluids of infected people, for example, serum, semen, saliva, and vaginal secretions. An infant can acquire hepatitis B infection from an infected mother, through transmission at birth, or from a chronically infected member of the household. The natural history of hepatitis B infection is diagrammed here. Acute hepatitis B can be symptomatic or asymptomatic, with eventual resolution and development of immunity, or eventual failure to resolve with development of chronic hepatitis B infection. Each year, chronic hepatitis B infection resolves in a small proportion of people who become immune. However, in most people, chronic hepatitis B persists with a 15 to 25% lifetime risk of liver cirrhosis or liver cancer. The risk of developing chronic hepatitis B is dramatically different by age at infection. Chronic infection develops in 90% of infants, 30% of children younger than 6 years, and less than 5% of otherwise healthy adults. These statistics show that vaccination must start early to provide chronic hepatitis B infection, to prevent chronic hepatitis B infection, which poses the highest risk of liver complications. So why is the birth dose of hepatitis B vaccine so important? The primary goal of administering hepatitis B vaccine at birth is to protect babies from chronic infection, liver failure, and liver cancer. Most morbidity and mortality from hepatitis B-related liver failure and cancer occurs in people with chronic infection. Treatment can reduce liver damage and the chance of liver cancer, but there is no cure. Many people with chronic hepatitis B are not aware of their infection and can unknowingly spread the infection. What is the effectiveness of the hepatitis B vaccine when started at birth? Post-exposure prophylaxis of infants born to hepatitis B infected mothers is 85 to 95% effective when started within 12 hours of birth. Post-exposure prophylaxis consists of administering the first dose of hepatitis B vaccine and hepatitis B immune globulin at birth, that is within 12 hours, followed by completing the vaccination series and testing for outcomes, immunity or infection. The timing of the birth dose is critical to achieve the highest rates of protection. Hepatitis B vaccination starting at birth, even without HBIG, will prevent transmission of the infection in 70 to 95% of infants born to infected mothers. Hospitals have an important opportunity to protect the future health of infants born at their facilities. Each year in the U.S., more than 24,000 infants are born to women who are infected with hepatitis B, and not all of their infants receive post-exposure prophylaxis. Even when mothers are not infected, some infants are exposed shortly after birth by household members or caretakers who have chronic hepatitis B infection. Most of these infants can be protected if hospitals routinely provide a birth dose of hepatitis B vaccine to all newborn infants. The problem is that many infants in the U.S. are not receiving the first dose of hepatitis B vaccine at birth. According to the latest National Immunization Survey conducted from July 2011 to June 2012, only 70% of U.S. infants received hepatitis B vaccine within 3 days of birth, and fewer received the vaccine at birth. State coverage rates varied between 29% and 88%. Although these are the most recent statistics, they demonstrate that there is room for improvement in protecting newborn infants in every state. Why should we give hepatitis B vaccine to all newborns? Hepatitis B vaccine starting at birth prevents mother-to-infant transmission. Vaccination alone prevents 70 to 95% of hepatitis B infections among infants born to hepatitis B surface antigen positive women. Vaccination starting at birth prevents household transmission by protecting infants from infected family members and other caregivers. And importantly, hepatitis B vaccine starting at birth protects when medical errors occur by providing a safety net to prevent perinatal transmission. Why is a safety net needed? Because medical errors occur. Some of the types of medical errors that have been reported are listed here. Ordering the wrong hepatitis B screening test for the infant's mother. Misinterpreting or mistranscribing the mother's hepatitis B test results. Failing to communicate the hepatitis B surface antigen test result to the hospital or within the hospital. Not giving hepatitis B vaccine to infants born to mothers of unknown hepatitis B surface antigen status within 12 hours of birth. Not giving prophylaxis to an infant even when the mother is known and documented to be hepatitis B surface antigen positive. Because of these types of errors, children are becoming chronically infected with hepatitis B virus. A universal hepatitis B vaccine birth dose policy helps to protect newborn infants from human error and the resulting chronic hepatitis B virus infection, which can cause serious liver disease. To protect newborn infants, all birthing hospitals can and should implement policies and procedures to administer the recommended universal hepatitis B vaccine birth dose, ensuring that every newborn infant receives hepatitis B vaccine at birth or no later than hospital discharge, regardless of the mother's hepatitis B surface antigen result. Birthing hospitals should implement standing or routine orders for administering hepatitis B vaccine as part of routine medical care of all medically stable infants weighing 2,000 or more grams at birth. And birthing hospitals should follow national recommendations for prophylaxis of all infants born to women who have hepatitis B surface antigen positive test results and all infants born to women whose hepatitis B surface antigen status is unknown, regardless of the infant's birth weight. In addition, birthing hospitals should ensure that a copy of the original laboratory report from the mother's hepatitis B surface antigen screening test is placed in the infant's medical record, and they should educate staff and parents about the importance of administering the first dose of hepatitis B vaccine in the hospital or birthing facility without delaying it until after discharge. The ACIP states that only in rare circumstances and on a case-by-case basis should the first dose be delayed until after discharge. Such a delay should be considered only for the infant who weighs 2,000 grams or more and whose mother is surface antigen negative during this pregnancy. If the first dose is delayed, then a physician's order to withhold the dose should be placed in the infant's medical record along with a copy of the mother's original laboratory report demonstrating that she was hepatitis B surface antigen negative during this pregnancy. The hepatitis B birth dose is recommended by the Advisory Committee on Immunization Practices of the CDC, the American Academy of Pediatrics, the American Academy of Family Physicians, and the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists. Administer monovalent hepatitis B vaccine to all newborns before hospital discharge. There is an increasing interest in monitoring hospital and birthing facility birth dose coverage as a quality measure. On April 2, 2012, the National Quality Forum endorsed quality measure number 0475, which recommends that hospitals measure and report the percentage of live newborns that receive hepatitis B vaccination before discharge at each single hospital or birthing facility during a given time period, which is usually 1 year, excluding infants whose parents refuse vaccination. Calculation of birth dose coverage according to measure specifications has been programmed for electronic medical records by the Centers for Medicaid and Medicare Services. This programming is undergoing pilot testing and release is expected this year. Understanding hospital-based birth dose coverage may be useful for improving facility-specific coverage. In summary, birthing facilities play a critical role in preventing chronic hepatitis B infections through timely initiation of post-exposure prophylaxis and by creating a birth dose safety net for eliminating all perinatal hepatitis B transmission. The most important steps for birthing facilities to take are to implement a universal birth dose policy, ensure universal review of original maternal hepatitis B surface antigen test results, implement standard admission orders for timely admission of hepatitis B vaccine to all newborns, and follow national recommendations for prophylaxis of newborn infants identified to be at risk, including infants born to women with hepatitis B surface antigen positive test results and infants born to women whose hepatitis B surface antigen status is unknown. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you so much, Dr. Murphy. Next, we will be hearing from first Lynn Pollock and then Mary Miller, discussing a case study from Albany Medical Center.
Thank you, Dr. Blog. I want to talk just briefly about the New York State Perinatal Hepatitis B program. As Dr. Blog mentioned earlier, it began in 1990 with the enactment of a public health law mandating the screening of all pregnant women for each pregnancy. Along with that law came some regulations and provisions also for reporting results, as well as for providing treatment of post-exposure prophylaxis of infants born to hepatitis B surface antigen positive women and women with unknown status. Within 3 years of the enactment of the law, the New York State Department of Health began an on-site record review using the lot quality assurance process to monitor compliance, not only with the law, but to ensure that infants received post-exposure prophylaxis treatment. This practice continues today. In 1999, as many of you remember, there were concerns about thimerosal in vaccines. We saw a dramatic decline in the uptake and the administration of the hepatitis B birth dose. In response to that, in 2002, the New York State Department of Health conducted a survey looking at barriers to give the hepatitis B birth dose. And quite obviously, the number one barrier was the cost of the vaccine. In response to that, the following year, the Hospital Birth Dose Initiative was launched. It was a voluntary initiative, and actually by 2008, all 102 birthing hospitals in New York State were enrolled in this voluntary program. I want to also mention another major milestone in our effort to promote the hepatitis B birth dose in New York State, and that came in 2006 when our commissioner established a new standard of care. The standard of care in New York State was and continues to be to give the hepatitis B birth dose within 12 hours of birth to all medically stable infants, 2,000 grams or more. Now, this is a departure from the ACIP and AA recommendation to administer the vaccine before hospital discharge. However, we felt that in order to provide a true safety net against the documented medical errors that we identified, the birth dose needed to be administered within the 12-hour time frame to provide maximum post-exposure benefit for the newborn born to the hepatitis B surface antigen-positive woman. And just a few words about our birth dose, our universal birth dose initiative. The goal, of course, was to eliminate the transmission of hepatitis B and have birth dose rates for every birthing hospital greater than or equal to 90%. Now, we set this 90% goal because it was similar to, it was the 2010 Healthy People goal. But as I mentioned previously, this was a voluntary initiative, and it was started in October of 2003. So all hospitals were enrolled by 2008. The key benefit of this initiative was to remove vaccine cost barrier. After the hospital adopted an approved universal birth dose policy, which included enrollment in the VFC program, the vaccine was provided to all newborns. The policy needed to include, at a very minimum, standing orders offering the vaccine, regardless of the mother's hepatitis B surface antigen status, the individual provider's preference, or the infant's insurance status. In addition to the standing orders, parental consent to vaccinate it also needed to be obtained. But in New York State, that could be either written or documented verbal consent. So this is what our birth dose rates look like. In 2008, we set the 90% state goal, and we began tracking those birth dose rates using our immunization registry. Because our registry didn't capture birth weight, we are currently using a combination of immunization registry and electronic birth certificate data to track hospital birth dose percentages. This allows us to exclude low birth weight infants less than 2,000 grams from our total number of live births. You can see from this chart the remarkable progress that Albany Medical Center has made in achieving their birth dose rates, and beginning in 2010, and far exceed the 90% New York State goal. So at this point, I would like to invite Mary Miller from Albany Medical Center's birthplace to share their experiences with the New York State Birth Dose Initiative.
Thank you very much. A little bit about Albany Medical Center. It's a 631-bed hospital, increasing to 714 beds by the end of 2013. More than 35,000 admissions are expected in 2013. From 2001 to 2012, hospitalized patients have increased by 42%. In 2012, 8,500 were patient transfers to Albany Med from other hospitals. There are approximately 2,100 deliveries at Albany Medical Center's birthplace each year. Albany Medical Center is the only academic health center in northeastern New York. We deliver unique and critical services that our patients, physicians, and community hospitals rely on around the clock every day. Albany Med reaches more than 3 million people in northeastern New York and western New England. And this is just a slide to show you the amount of maternal and newborn neonatal transports from 2004 to 2012. We did have, in an attempt to meet the goals of the universal newborn hepatitis B dose, we had a policy and we had a standing order, and it relied on staff from postpartum asking patients on admission to the postpartum unit whether they would like to receive the hepatitis B vaccine. And the vaccine was administered when the mother gave consent. Some barriers we had: when patients are transferred to the postpartum unit, they're screened for multiple parameters: HIV status, blood type, Rogam status, rubella status, influenza, Tdap, and pneumococcal vaccine. And screening for the newborn hepatitis B vaccine relied on individual nurse screening prior to discharge. In 2009, we initiated a baby nurse program. The postpartum nurses were going to attend all births and labor and delivery, completing newborn care from birth till transfer to the postpartum unit. Prior to that, a labor and delivery staff would assign someone that was free to complete newborn care. They would go in, make sure everything was fine, and then the one nurse took care of the mom and the baby. It took us about a year to orient all the postpartum nurses to have 24/7 availability. And these mother baby staff started discussing hepatitis B vaccine dose with the parents in labor and delivery, and most agreed to the vaccine. By asking parents in labor and delivery, more parents accepted the birth dose to hepatitis B vaccine. Discussing the newborn separate from maternal screening gave the couple time to make decision for their newborn. Having a mother-baby nurse dedicated to infant care and labor and delivery facilitates administration of the vaccine prior to the newborn's admission to the term nursery, so does make that less than 12-hour mark. In the NICU, they're currently a 50-bed unit, but will move to the new patient tower this fall and will have 60 private rooms. The NICU has approximately 800 admissions annually. About one-third of these admissions are transported from other hospitals or admitted from our ED. About two-thirds of the admissions are born at Albany Med. The RNs there give the CDC vaccine information as we do for the parents to review. They document in the electronic record that the information was received. The medical providers are available to discuss the importance of vaccine with the parents and answer any questions. The medical team in NICU discusses on rounds when the infant is eligible for the vaccine based on their medical condition. The parents give verbal consent, an order is written, and it's administered by NARAN. Documentation is again completed in the electronic medical record. Education with parents by the RN and medical provider allows families to make informed decisions about the health and welfare of their infant. I'd like to thank all the nurses who made it possible. Their vigilance in assuring that all newborns are immunized against hepatitis B is what has helped Albany Med achieve great success in decreasing the transmission of hepatitis B.
Thank you so much, Lynn and Mary. And our final presenter is Dr. Deborah Wexler, Executive Director of the Immunization Action Coalition. She will discuss IAC's initiative to eliminate hepatitis B virus infection in the U.S. through the prevention of perinatal transmission.
Thank you, Dr. Blog. Before I start my portion of the presentation, I must congratulate Albany Medical Center and the state of New York for their absolutely stellar achievements in implementing the hepatitis B vaccine birth dose for the babies at their hospital and for throughout the state of New York. Give Birth to the End of Hep B is an initiative of the Immunization Action Coalition. Our goal is to eliminate hepatitis B virus transmission in the United States through the prevention of perinatal transmission. As part of IAC's new initiative, Give Birth to the End of Hep B, we've created two major new tools that I will be presenting today. The first is our new comprehensive guidebook titled Hepatitis B, What Hospitals Need to Do to Protect Newborns, a Comprehensive Guide. And the second is IAC's new Hepatitis B Birth Dose Honor Roll. Both of these materials are available at our website at www.immunize.org/protect-newborns. And for those of you who might have joined late today, you can see the slides for this presentation today. They're available on the website right now. I'm very pleased to inform you that our new guidebook has been reviewed and endorsed by the American Academy of Family Physicians, the American Academy of Pediatrics, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists, and the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. You can read the letter of endorsement at the link at the bottom of this page, of this slide, and the letter also appears in page 2 of the guidebook. The new book is pictured here. This is the cover. It's 85 pages in length, and it's divided into 5 sections. Chapter 1 is an overview about the importance of the birth dose. Chapter 2 addresses the issue of medical errors. The third chapter contains practical tools that hospitals need to help improve their prevention programs and also tools they can use with parents. And the fourth chapter provides hospitals with contacts of the VFC program and perinatal hepatitis B coordinators who can help them implement the birth dose strategies. The last section is an appendix which provides excellent additional resources. And the link at the bottom of the slide provides you direct access to the book, as well as the table of contents where you can actually download chapters of the book, the entire book, or individual pages of the book. Now I'm going to briefly highlight each section of the book. Chapter 1 is titled Preventing Hepatitis B in Newborns, What's Needed? It contains the executive summary, which provides the rationale for administering the birth dose of hepatitis B vaccine to all babies before hospital discharge. The chapter also contains information that Dr. Murphy discussed about the National Quality Forum and its newly established newborn hepatitis B vaccination as a national standard for measurement by healthcare settings. Going forward, the link at the bottom of each of the slides will take you directly to the full chapter that I'm discussing on this particular slide. Chapter 2, Reducing Medical Errors, Case Reports, provides readers with 5 different articles describing serious medical errors that have been reported in healthcare settings. The first article states report hundreds of medical errors in perinatal hepatitis B prevention, is a 4-page summary article written by the Immunization Action Coalition after we surveyed all the nation's perinatal hepatitis B coordinators. And they told us about the errors that they had discovered when working with hospitals. The second article, Unprotected Infant Dies of Fulminant Hepatitis B, is a tragic case report about the death of a 3-month-old infant in Michigan who wasn't vaccinated at birth and died from overwhelming hepatitis B infection. The third article contains 6 case reports of medical errors from the state of New York. The fourth article contains 2 case reports from the state of Colorado. And the last article, Give the Birth Dose, Hepatitis B Vaccine at Birth Saves Lives, was authored by me and summarizes the problem of medical errors. Chapter 3, Addressing the Problem, Practical Tools, and this slide focuses on the tools for hospitals. The first article in the section is Guidance for Developing Admission Orders in Labor and Delivery Units. This will help hospitals develop written policies for making sure that pregnant women are appropriately screened and all newborns are fully vaccinated and properly managed in the hospital. The second article titled Sample Text for Developing Admission Orders in Newborn Units for the Hep B Birth Dose is text that can actually be cut and pasted and of course modified as desired for placement into newborn admission orders, along with such treatments as vitamin K and eye ointment to prevent infection, to make sure that every baby in the nursery receives hepatitis B vaccine routinely, like all the other routine treatments. This slide shows the sample text article that I just mentioned, and it's ready to cut and paste, as I mentioned, and ready for your use. Chapter 3, Addressing the Problem. These are the practical tools that can be used with parents. It includes information about the hepatitis B vaccine information statements, and the book provides them in both English and Spanish. The book also contains this chapter also contains a copy of IAC's newly designed handout for parents titled Hepatitis B Shots Are Recommended for All New Babies. This brochure was actually our first brochure that we ever created, and it's been in existence since 1991. It's now newly designed. I'll show you the new format of it on our next slide, but before we go there, Chapter 3 also contains information about the importance of parents having a childhood immunization record card and where hospitals can obtain them. This is the newly designed Hep B Shots Are Recommended for All New Babies, and it's in the book and ready to be downloaded and copied and handed out to parents. Chapter 4, Obtaining Support, Helpful Contacts. This section is brief in the book, but it describes who the state and local perinatal hepatitis B coordinators are and how they can help you implement the hepatitis B birth dose. The second part is how the Vaccines for Children program can help your hospital. And both of these pages give you links to where you can go to get your state's contact information on the individuals in your state who can help you. The last section is the appendix, authoritative resources. The first item in the appendix is a reprint of CDC's ACIP hepatitis B recommendations for infants, where we've inserted yellow highlighting, as you can note on this slide. So to draw your attention to some of the most important ACIP guidance, which is often overlooked. Second is an article from the journal Pediatrics published in 2010 that surveyed hospitals across the country and describes significant gaps that persist in hospital policies in perinatal hepatitis B prevention. And the article concludes that efforts to avoid medical errors are needed. The last section of the appendix features more materials, educational materials about the birth dose from CDC, and provides information about the new 7th edition of Guidelines for Perinatal Care, which is a book co-authored by the American Academy of Pediatrics and the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists. The reprint of CDC's ACIP recommendations in the guidebook uses yellow highlighting in 13 places to point out to birthing institutions the exact language of the recommendations that stresses that the first dose of hepatitis B vaccine is clearly recommended in the hospital before discharge, rather than delaying the first dose until a subsequent office visit. For example, as you can see from the yellow that's highlighted here, the recommendation states, on a case-by-case basis and only in rare circumstances, the first dose may be delayed until after hospital discharge. We think this yellow highlighting makes the important language much easier for hospitals to locate in the 34-page document that is the ACIP recommendations. And now that you've heard about the new guidebook, I'm pleased to announce that today IAC has launched the Hepatitis B Birth Dose Honor Roll. Today in Albany, New York, where we are broadcasting, and just before this webinar began, as Dr. Blog stated, we held a ceremony honoring Albany Medical Center. We celebrated their achievement of vaccinating 99% of newborns prior to hospital discharge, and in addition to that, within 12 hours of birth. With this achievement, IAC honored them as the inaugural member of the Hepatitis B Birth Dose Honor Roll. And we hope there will be thousands more birthing institutions who will be future honorees. The Honor Roll recognizes hospitals and birthing centers that have attained 90% or greater coverage rates for administering hepatitis B vaccine at birth. The Honor Roll link is located on this slide, and you can go there today. I'm sure you're wondering about the criteria for birth dose enrollment. The criteria are based on CDC recommendations and include the following. At least 90% of babies, that is babies weighing 2,000 grams or more, who are born during a 12-month period, receive hepatitis B vaccine prior to discharge. A second criteria, written policies, procedures, and protocols for implementing the birth dose, for implementing the universal hepatitis B vaccine birth dose, are in place and include the following. That parents be informed about the importance of the birth dose and that it is recommended for all newborns. That all infants routinely receive hepatitis B vaccine before hospital discharge. that staff review the HBsAg test result on all women admitted to labor and delivery. It is recommended to review a copy of the original test report, if at all possible, and it's actually recommended to review a it isn't if at all possible, but you should do that because so many errors can occur if you when records are transcribed, when test results are transcribed, and when the wrong test is ordered. If the HBsAg test result is not on the chart, it is ordered ASAP. That infants born to HBsAg positive mothers receive hepatitis B vaccine and hepatitis B immune globulin within 12 hours of birth. That infants born to mothers whose HBsAg status is unknown receive hepatitis B vaccine within 12 hours of birth and also receive HBIG within 12 hours of birth if they weigh less than 2,000 grams. That newborn admission orders include a standing order to administer hepatitis B vaccine to all infants. And that state or local health department perinatal hepatitis B prevention programs are notified prior to discharge for all mothers whose HBsAg test result is positive. Well, enrollment into the birth dose honor roll will happen like this. Applications are accepted at immunize.org/honor roll/birth dose at this link on your slide. And IAC reviews the applications. IAC notifies applicants of their acceptance and mails a certificate of enrollment in the honor roll, suitable for framing and display, to those birthing institutions. Hospital or birthing center's names and corresponding state are listed on the birth dose honor roll webpage on IAC's website. And the birthing institution is recognized through an announcement in IAC Express. IAC Express is IAC's free weekly email news service and has nearly 50,000 subscribers. If you haven't subscribed yet, you can do so at the link on this slide. This is an image of the certificate Albany Medical Center received today. IAC will be thrilled to send them out to many more birthing institutions who submit applications and meet the criteria for the honor roll in the months to come. What are the things you can do now? Well, you can download the guidebook from immunize.org/protect-newborns. You can share the guide with hospitals and birthing centers to help them improve their birth dose coverage rates. You can distribute our new handout, Give Birth to the End of Hep B, to educate others about the importance of the hepatitis B birth dose. And I'll show you that handout in just a minute. And if you're a hospital or a birthing center that has achieved a 90% or greater birth dose rate, you can apply for enrollment into the birth dose honor roll at the link on the slide. This is the handout we've developed to help you in promoting the hepatitis B birth dose. It's available both in black and white, if you're using a black and white copier, or in color if you use a color copier. Both are available at immunize.org/protect-newborns. Lastly, this final slide so clearly shows why we all do and why you all who are listening today do what you do. Create a safety net to protect newborns. Thank you.
I would like to thank Trudy Murphy, Lynn Pollock, Mary Miller, and Deborah Wexler for those excellent presentations. I would also like to thank you all for attending this very important webinar. The webinar slide set and recording will be available on the IAC's website in the next few days. For more information and for seeing the webinar, please visit www.immunize.org/protect-newborns. In the meantime, questions about give birth to the end of Hep B, the honor roll, and the webinar can be emailed to birthdose@immunize.org. Thank you all for listening.